Using the R open source programming language in our stories, we can perform statistical analysis and create visualizations that reflect those results using a variety of techniques such as linear and nonlinear modeling, time series analysis, and clustering. Note that to add R visualizations to a story, we must have an R server running and configured to connect to SAP Analytics Cloud. This connection is set up by an administrator and includes the server address and port number, a certificate for encryption, and user credentials. If we test the configuration, we can see that the R server is running and ready to process our requests. In our story, we can add the R visualization object to the canvas. An empty R visualization is added to the canvas page. In this example, we'll set up the visualization to show the network of sales managers. First, we'll specify what input data we want to run the script on. Note that if a data source has already been added to the story, it will be used by default for any new objects. In this example, we need to select a different model. If we expand the panel, we can see the default dimensions with the associated data displayed in table format. We'll add dimensions to the table so that the relevant data we need is available. We can also apply filters that can be referenced in the script for the visualization, either by applying a filter here or by defining a new set of input data. In this example, we'll add a filter that limits the results to those sales managers who are similar to a specific manager. This new input data will then be referenced in the script to return the results we want. Once the input is set up, we can define the script itself. Again, we'll expand the panel. Here, we have access to a dashboard that follows the same format as RStudio, providing a familiar environment for running scripts. It includes an RScript editor, a snapshot of the environment after the RScript is run, a console that shows the output of the executed script, and a preview screen that renders the visualization. If we need help to get started with R, we also have access to a code snippet that lets us list all the installed packages on our R server, and to several examples. Now we'll add our script to the editor pane. Note that in the editor pane, we can search for specific terms in our script and undo or redo changes. The script itself includes statements that load the packages needed for the rest of the script, a series of formulas that sum up values from the input data, and instructions on how to render the associated chart. When we execute the script, the variables from the output are listed in the environment pane, where we can search for terms or filter on data, values, or functions. The output from the executed script is displayed in the console pane, and the visualization is rendered in the preview pane. If we then apply our changes, the same chart is rendered on the canvas. Note that any row-level security on the input data is respected when it's presented to users in the visualization. If we need to make adjustments, we can edit the script. Here, we'll change the script to display the nodes in maroon instead of orange. The change to the script is reflected in the visualization. Thanks for watching.